Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the 2016 Under-15 National Championships here in sunny Wellington. We've got our first girls semi-final coming up with Waikato taking on Taranaki. With me in the commentary box is Morgan Maskell, coach of North Harbour, recent champions of the Under-17 boys last week. How are you getting on, Morgan?
Yeah, not too bad. Nice to be here, Connor. And just got a quick win. I'm with the Under-15B girls here for North Harbour. We got our first win today, so that was really good for our girls. And good to win with the boys last week. And we see here we've got a semi-final between Taranaki and Waikato. Waikato's been a pretty strong program in the girls for the last few years. They won the Under-15, Under-17 and Under-19 titles last year. And they're just coming off the Under-17 girls title last week.
As you would know, watching that one from the sidelines before your game.
Yeah, that's right. They had Charlize Ledger-Walker coming off her NZ Under-16 campaign, you know, leading them, another MVP for her. And we're looking at another really well-coached Waikato team here. Their head coach is Tyler Wilkinson, and she's had many, many national titles in the past, and she's probably looking for another one here with this really strong team.
You're right, she's no stranger to a national championship. So we've got Taranaki coming up the court quickly here. Quick miss from them.
See, their big is really strong inside, and that's going to be really an interesting battle between 15 for Waikato, Dominique Stevens, and number 5 for Taranaki, Emily Poole. Don't often have a lot of strong bigs in under-15 girls basketball, so this is really good to see in the girls' game for our development internationally.
Absolutely, you're not wrong. Taranaki going through the pool play unbeaten. Just having a look, were they even really tested?
I mean, Rotorua was the other team that got through from their pool, and they really breezed past Rotorua 68-46, yeah. So quite comfortably in the end, and probably got to play a lot of their bench towards the end of that game.
It wasn't a strong pool that pulled D, so.
Yeah, Rotorua, they got crushed in the quarterfinal by Harbour A this morning, and so you can see the strength of the pools there. So Harbour A's through to their next semi against Canterbury.
And that'll come up after this game, following this game, the second girls semi-final, and following those games will be the boys' semi-finals. Going to the line now is number
5, Emily Poole. It's their big. Really promising young athlete. A lot of these Taranaki girls play netball as well as basketball, so I'm sure all the talent ID scouts for New Zealand basketball would love to see them stick with basketball, especially with that size and athleticism.
Absolutely. Waikato now looking to see something up with a handoff.
Yeah, they really look to go through number 8, their point guard, Walker Eketone, sorry. Really strong player, really smart, really strong with the ball.
Yeah, as you said before, the factory of players coming out of the women's side in Waikato, it just seems to continue, even through a massive leap up with most of the under-15 girls going to 17s this year. It looks like they've got a strong background coming up year after year.
Yeah, they're just in the top 4 every year, and like we said last year, they even won the region won the secondary schools competition at St. Peter's Cambridge. You see here is a quick foul, Taranaki ball. You'll see Taranaki's number 15 is Caitlin O'Connell. She's got the ball now at point. And she was in the, and that's a lovely move from Caitlin O'Connell. She's showing her experience. She was in the New Zealand under-16 team that went over to state champs a couple weeks ago in Melbourne. She was a really strong player, and Taranaki will look to put a lot of their plays through her. See here, Dominique Stevens with the ball now. Loses the ball. Unfortunately, no call for her. We see Taranaki coming back up the court now. Mason. Not a strong move to the hoop there, unfortunately. They're looking to get a foul call there, maybe. Maybe they just need to be a little more composed. That Waikato defense is really strong, and that's been the backbone of their championships for the last few years now. It's good to see Waikato. They're playing with a lot of structure out there, looking to run offense. And that's, again, really good for the development of the girls' game. Internationally, as we look to grow our game. Next year, New Zealand's in the Asia Pacific zone, looking to qualify for the world champs in the under 17 age group. Real promising. So, Taranaki running a lot of handoff plays. There are a lot of guards with one big out there. Mason with the ball now. They put it inside to Poole. That's a strong move. She's unlucky, and Stevens gets the rebound for Waikato. Up the court, Leith for Waikato. Unlucky there, and that's off Taranaki, so Waikato ball. It's really great quality we have here. I'd like to thank the New Zealand Herald for live streaming this event. It's really great coverage, and we didn't have any of this many years ago. They streamed the under 17 nationals in Auckland last week, and they also streamed the NBL throughout the season in lieu of TV coverage. Unlucky Waikato, we've got to travel there. Really low scoring game so far, almost 3.5 minutes in, still only 3-0 to Taranaki, with points coming off the free throw line and a layup from Caitlin O'Connell. O'Connell with the ball again, really in control, and that'll be an interesting battle between Walker Ikitone, number 8, the Waikato point guard, and number 15, Caitlin O'Connell, the Taranaki point guard. Right there, a really strong move from Raquel Sampson, number 4, she gets an and one. And Coach Tyler Wilkinson with an early timeout, 5-0 Taranaki after 3.5 minutes. You can see Coach Tyler Wilkinson not impressed in the huddle there. She's really revving her players up, and they've played really well-structured, composed basketball all tournament, so she won't be happy with the first 3.5 minutes of gameplay there. Still a 5-point gap, though, and a long game to go. Taranaki coach Andy Cowie looking to draw something out after this timeout. And they haven't made any substitutions so far. We come back now, and Sampson has one free throw after the and one play. And we just see if there's any change-ups out of this. Out of these timeouts for these teams, probably some more intensity, maybe a bit of pressing from Waikato. And a really good save there. And Poole unlucky with the travel there, but a really good save from Mason, and that's a promising sign for Taranaki to be playing with that much hustle early in the game. It really comes down to desire and want at this sort of stage of the competition. This is a national semi-final. That's a huge foot on the line there, but that still opens Waikato's account, and they're down 5-2 right now. Caitlin O'Connell calmly under pressure with her left hand, and that's her offhand. And again, really just good to see the skill improvement that we have, in a really nice basket there from Poole. Just really impressive to see guards like O'Connell dribbling under pressure with their offhand. Bigs like Emily Poole stepping out and shooting a mid-range jumper like that really expands their game, and we're really starting to produce multi-skilled players in New Zealand. Blyde coming up the court now for Taranaki, keeps them under control nicely. Off to Mason, who looks to initiate a lot of their offense. And an attempted pass into Poole, but Sampson gets it, and she's fouled by Stevens, and that'll be huge for Waikato. And she's getting told by the coach now, Stevens is in foul trouble. They lose a lot of size, and against the bigs of Taranaki, Sampson and Poole, they might really struggle. Taranaki extend their advantage with that free throw. Walker Ikitone coming up the court now, looking to spark something for Waikato. Stevens is staying in the game at this stage with one foul, and if she picks up another foul in this first quarter, that could really change the game, because they really look to play through her there. See in the high post, And that's a really risky pass there, but luckily Waikato get it back. 8 left on the shot clock for Waikato. And Taranaki just getting out hustled on that box out. Samson looked to get a block there, but unfortunately for her teammate Poole was pulled up for a blocking foul. So Waikato will go to the line for 2 shots here. But situations like these where games are won and lost, free throws, especially at this age group, a lot of missed free throws. If teams are shooting free throws poorly and their opposition are shooting free throws well, that can make a huge difference at the semi-final stage. And even though it's 8-2 right now, now 8-3, we still anticipate a really close game at this stage. A turnover from Taranaki here, and we could see a shift in momentum. You know, both teams were in the semi-finals last year, and this is a repeat of last year's semi-final that Waikato won handily at the hands of Charlize Ledger-Walker, who really dominated the flow of the game and ended up winning MVP for the championship-winning Waikato side last year. So Taranaki will look to reverse their fortunes this year. In the other semi-final, we have North Harbour, who are back to the semi-finals. Where they were last year, and they played ACM last year in the semi-finals and won through to the final. And this year they're playing Canterbury in the semi-final. Well-polished sides, and that'll be another good game just like this one. Really messy game at the moment. Both teams looking to turn it over, not a lot of ball security, and that will be something that both coaches will really be looking to rectify as much as they can coming into this late stage of the first quarter, with the score still being 8-3 to Taranaki. And Caitlin O'Connell on the drive now, right through traffic. Deceptively strong there. She's not that big compared to all the other guards, but manages to weave through a lot of bodies and get up a shot through contact that almost landed. She'll go to the line for 2 shots. Taranaki's still not made any subs at this stage. Still only 6 minutes in. And O'Connell hits that first free throw. And she hits the second free throw. Experienced player, and that'll matter in the end for Taranaki. Waikato running their offense. And it's perhaps a rush shot, a contested 3 there for Waikato. And Caitlin O'Connell calmly dribbling the ball up against pressure. Well, that's a bad turnover from her. That's live play. Great defense, but unfortunately turnovers like that against this polished team like Waikato are going to get punished. That's a good layup from Hemi Ta'ala. Again, that's walking out of bounds. That's another bad turnover that the Taranaki coach Andy Cow is really going to want to look to avoid. And the first sub for Taranaki there, number 6, Paris Mason, comes off. And we see the entrance of number 10, Liana Smith. Waikato looking patient, drive and kick, and then a 3-point shot there from Walker Ikitone. Now surely she has the green light from the coach to shoot, and she's one of their strongest guards. Nice and patient around the outside. Waikato relying a lot on the 3 ball, but that's a swish like that from Hemi Ta'ala suggests that perhaps that might not be a bad strategy. Good shot forms, good technique, and a good make there. Good defense there from Stevens. Nice and long, straight up, and avoids that foul call. Stevens with a move to the hoop. Sampson equal to the challenge though. Taranaki launch a three of their own, but to no avail. Waikato up the court now on a fast break. 2-on-1, and that's good 2-on-1 basketball. Oh, unlucky. Good poor foul, but great basket there from Waikato, and that makes it 10-9, and we've got a game. Again, it's a really good facility here in Wellington, the ASB Stadium. If I look around where I am, you can see six courts going, and there's another six courts on the other side that run holiday programs and things like that. Tournament host Wellington Basketball have done really well with this tournament, and they have had this tournament for about 3 or 4 years now, and they're just getting better and better at organization. And unfortunately, foot on the line there and a missed three. It's interesting to see a team rely on three-point shots so much at this level. But if anything, it's probably good for the game if we can develop consistent shots, especially if we want to qualify for world champs in that Asia zone. Nice strong move there from number seven, Owen, and a great hustle play from Poole there. But unfortunately, Poole has given a foul call. And that's her second foul. Emily Poole on two fouls. It's really unfortunate. That must mean Raquel Sampson's going to have to step up for Taranaki, who's on the bench at the moment. Doesn't look like the Taranaki coach, Andy Cow, is going to make a move to take her off, though. Good steal from her. If that was her third foul in the first quarter, though, Coach Cowie may rue that decision to keep her on the court. Great drive from O'Connell there. Unfortunately, she misses. And the refs have a foul call. O'Connell's reaching after that. And it'll be Waikato ball. So we're still 10-9 here. Taranaki with the advantage still, but the game is certainly evened out after that fast start from Taranaki. Walker Ikitone again, calmly initiating their offense as they look to swing it around the perimeter, waiting patiently for a shot to develop. Good drive from her, and there's a foul call there. And that really rewards their patient offense, really just being patient, waiting to get in the key, and then they got a nice shot out of that, ended up getting fouled, and here's an opportunity for them to take the lead for the first time this game. Good basket by Stevens there. Again, these strong bigs, I mean, that could really be the difference. We've got some real star power here, and you'll probably see these ladies in the New Zealand singlet probably in the future if they really keep working on their game like they are. Great move there from Poole, and she gets her own O-board. And a foul on Waikato. That's number seven, Kemi Ta'ala. And they're in the bonus, so they'll be shooting two here. Important for Poole to hit these to break the scoring drought and hopefully get a good stop on the other end for Taranaki. And she banks it in, but it still counts. And 12-11 is the score now. Walker Tony up against O'Connell. Very uncharacteristic. Throws the ball away there. Could be a sign of fatigue, perhaps, but she will probably be called on to play big minutes in this game. So she's going to need to avoid turnovers like that. And that puts the ball back in Taranaki's hand with Caitlin O'Connell. Strong drive in the middle, draws a bunch of defenders. Unfortunately, her teammate Owen cannot finish the layup, but that's good basketball from Taranaki. Waikato get the ball back to Walker Ikitone. 15 seconds left, this will be the last shot. Nice offense again from Waikato, nice and patient. Walker Ikitone gets an open shot, and that is a good mid-range shot from one of their best guards. Great offense from Waikato, and you're really seeing here the coaching of Tyler Wilkinson, incredibly experienced coach, and their team is just measured and well drilled, and that could be the difference late in the game, as well as that belief that they are a championship team, as Waikato, as we said earlier, just producing talent after talent, championship after championship. And it's quarter time here, 14-12, Waikato up. We're just going to take a quick break. And we're back now for the second quarter. And the score is Waikato 14, Taranaki 12. Really close game here. I'd just like to thank the broadcast partners, NTEC, and this being live streamed on the New Zealand Herald right now, which is really great, again, for the game in New Zealand as it's an expanding game. And we see Taranaki, Emily Poole, just barging her way in the paint, insistent that she's going to get a basket. Unfortunate misses, but that's really strong play from her. And it's Taranaki ball on the baseline. And their inbound play, they get the ball to Blyde. Back inside to Sampson. And they're just missing those little dinkers and dumpers in there, but Caitlin O'Connell manages to get one in again in tall traffic in the paint. It's really nice touch and composure. And I mean, Taranaki is in a really good position. They've got the best player on the floor, Caitlin O'Connell from the New Zealand under 16 team, the only bottom age player for under 16s who is in that team. And she must come to this tournament with a lot of confidence in her game as she goes up against other lesser experienced guards. But I mean, she's definitely learning. Walker Ikitone, number 8 for Waikato, is no pushover. She is a very strong guard in this age group. And it's going to be a really good battle there at the point guard spots. And these bigs are really battling inside. Emily Poole on 2 fouls and Dominic Stevens on 1 foul. Ball back in O'Connell's hand for Taranaki. She directs traffic really nicely. Nice double post action. Some X cuts there from Taranaki. Poole giving it to her partner Sampson. I mean, they're missing those shots, but they're really out-rebounding Waikato. And Wilkinson, Coach Wilkinson, will really be looking for Stevens to be getting those sorts of rebounds. Must be tough. I mean, there's only one of Stevens and there's two twin towers for Taranaki. Number 4, Raquel Sampson, and number 5, Emily Poole. They try to get inside to Stevens, but not a great entry pass from Leaf for Waikato. A really good transition defense. We're really not seeing a lot of layups in transition here, which is what everyone's probably used to at the under 15 level. Just a stoppage in the game here as a ball rolls onto the court and Taranaki will resume play from the sideline. They get it into Sampson. It's back in O'Connell's hands. She looks to drive right on Stevens. Gets her right up, and that's a fantastic play from Caitlin O'Connell over Dominique Stevens, who's almost, she's about a foot taller than her. Waikato just patiently running their offense. They get it into Stevens on the block. Strong move and one. That's really great offense there, and the foul's on Raquel Sampson. And I think that might be Raquel Sampson's second foul as well. And with 7 minutes 41 to go in the second quarter, with Poole and Sampson on two fouls, they really haven't been able to take them off. And that would suggest that their depth at that position may not be great. And at 16 all, that would be a big loss to Taranaki if either of those girls picked up their third foul this quarter. Caitlin O'Connell hasn't come off for Taranaki either, so probably not a lot of depth there, and those girls might have to even play 40 minutes. But if they've been doing that all tournament, they could be used to it. But they have really breezed through the tournament so far, Taranaki. And their pool, as we mentioned earlier, their biggest challenger was Rotorua, and they won that game 68-46. Their other games against Wellington and Gisborne, they won by 20 to 30 points and beat Southland by around 40-odd points in their pool. And they had a quarterfinal this morning against Canterbury Country to get to this stage of the tournament. O'Connell putting great pressure now on Walker Iketone, but she doesn't seem fazed, as Waikato again, so well drilled, just getting into their offense. And Stevens, with a great drive from the elbow, gets another foul call. And she's on three now. I believe that foul was on number five, Emily Poole. Taranaki's star big player on three fouls with 7 minutes 15 left in the second quarter. And from where I am, I can see coach Andy Cowie looking at his bench, but he hasn't made a move to make a sub. And this really could determine the game right now. Emily Poole on three fouls, such a strong player for Taranaki. Dominic Stevens could really have her way if they bring her off, and Taranaki's rebounding advantage might disappear. Yeah, unfortunate travel there from number six, Paris Mason, for Taranaki. Again, getting slightly different looks every time, Waikato, really keeping the Taranaki defense on their toes. They have about three or four different offensive sets that they're running a lot, and they run them smoothly every time, and they're so composed, and they tend to look for that right option. As you see Taranaki get a fast break this time, not great transition defense from Waikato, and they end up giving up an and one. Number seven for Taranaki, T.N. Owen, managing to get that and one, finishing through contact. And that puts the scores level at 18 all midway through the second quarter. Again, I mean, even though they're running different looks, I mean, a lot of their offense is going through Walker Iketone with initiation, and then Dominique Stevens getting the ball in the high post or the low post. There's a foul there. That foul's on number eight, protesting her innocence, but that foul stands on number eight, Jada Ashby. And that'll see number seven, Layla Hemi-Ta'ala, go to the line. Misses the first there, and the scores remain level at 18 all. And Coach Andy Coward can't be happy with that. The point guard for Waikato getting their own rebound off their missed free throws, that's a bit of a coach killer right there. And out of that, Waikato get another foul call. And now head to the line again. This time it'll be number 12, Tyler Mitchell, heading to the line. And she misses the first, so that's three missed free throws in a row for Waikato. She managed to break the scoring drought and give her team the lead. 19-18 now, Waikato up. Caitlin O'Connell inbounds it, but gets it back quickly. It's a really good pass inside and a good finish there from number seven, Tian Owen. Waikato gets the ball at the floor quickly, strong drive, and a really nice layup there from Leaf. Again, they put the ball in O'Connell's hand, and she's really working hard against Waikato's extended pressure. And they dump the ball inside there. Sampson misses on that. The crowd's really calling for a foul there, I assume Taranaki supporters. Not a call there, though, and a turnover from O'Connell, which leads to a Walker Ikitoni, and they're going on a fast break now. Stevens, layup, strong finish from Stevens, and she is really playing well now. And that foul's on number seven, Owen. So we've seen our coach, Andy Cowie, he has put Emily Poole on the bench with her three fouls, and it'll be interesting to see how long they last with her on the bench. Waikato's now got a three-point advantage. Stevens going to the line to try and make it a four-point advantage. And she does just that, 24-20 now. And number seven for Waikato now, you'll notice Hemi Ta'ala trying to play a bit of a denial defense on Caitlin O'Connell coming up the court, but she does get the ball back and they look to initiate their offense. She drives, manages to draw two. Ashby had an open shot there, passed it up. They get the ball back to O'Connell. Tough drive, perhaps some contact, but no call. And Stevens with a strong rebound, and she is really the glue here for Waikato, producing a lot of their rebounds, a lot of their space being generated that she's taking up in the key there. Really giving some shooters space as they really are forced to guard Stevens. Stevens with a strong O-board and putback, but a foul's been called. I can tell you the Waikato supporters at the stadium are not happy with that. You can't be discouraged by that if you're the Waikato coach, Tyler Wilkinson. That's a real strong hustle there from Dominic Stevens on the boards. That's her second foul midway through the second quarter. Taranaki, they don't look as composed without O'Connell bringing it up, and I think Coach Wilkinson's really cottoned on to something here, really trying to deny her the ball, make one of the other Taranaki guards bring it up. Hard to know if it's intentional or not, but they're putting a lot of pressure on those other guards and sagging off O'Connell a little bit. Perhaps daring O'Connell to shoot the three as she's hit a couple of really nice baskets on the drive. Looking around the stadium now, the ASB Stadium in Wellington, you can see Wellington Basketball Association doing a great job here. I see over on court two right now, Wellington are up two in their boys' quarterfinal against Canterbury, 33-31, midway through the second quarter. And for more information, you can go to basketball.org.nz and you can see full draws, results, tournament information and photos on the Basketball New Zealand Facebook page and follow on Twitter at basketballnz. So Taranaki has managed to pick it back a little bit. It's 24-22 now with 3 minutes 49 to go. And this will give Coach Cowie some confidence. He's sat down his star big, Emily Poole, for quite a while now. But Raquel Sampson, number 4, has really done a good job just battling with number 15, Dominic Stevens. And Waikato just getting into their offense. Walker Ikitoni initiating at the top, an elbow pass to Stevens. Unfortunate travel for Walker Ikitoni, and the large Taranaki contingent that are on the sideline in the crowd are really happy with that. You can see this time it's Walker Ikitoni denying Caitlin O'Connell the ball. Be interesting to see at halftime, perhaps or out of a timeout, what Coach Cowie looks to do to combat Waikato looking to get the ball out of O'Connell's hands. Seeing right now Walker Ikitoni, number 8 for Waikato, really having her way, getting the ball whenever she wants to have the ball. So perhaps fight fire with fire. And Taranaki has called a timeout here, so it'll be really interesting to see what both teams look to do out of this timeout. key players, Dominic Stevens, Waikato's big, is on two fouls. And it'll be really interesting to see if they keep her out here for this last 3 minutes 19, as I don't believe she's been subbed yet. And she is on two fouls. They probably can't risk her getting a third, but maybe the risk is greater of taking her out. We're back, and it's Taranaki ball on the baseline here. And number 10 has been assigned to Caitlin O'Connell, and they've double-teamed her on the baseline there, but she manages to get free anyway. For Taranaki at the moment, Caitlin O'Connell's the only player that hasn't seen any time on the bench. So at this stage, perhaps likely that she'll be playing all 40 minutes. For Waikato, they've got Walker Ekitone and Dominic Stevens, obviously they're two key players that haven't been subbed yet. Also Leith hasn't been subbed yet at all, number 10, and she's been really great defensively especially. And you can see, mentioning Waikato's defense there, a shot clock violation, and that makes it their ball. Caitlin O'Connell with extended pressure on Walker Ekitone now. Manages to get free out of that, and the pressure kind of evaporates. Interesting to see if that was O'Connell's decision or a change up out of timeout by Coach Cowie. Waikato again just initiating their offense. And we'll get a really nice score out of that. And it's Taranaki don't seem to be combating that offense at all. Stevens still seems to be getting really quite easy entries into that high post area and then being able to hand off to a guard. Scrappy in the middle now, only 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Ball in O'Connell's hands. She drives hard right on Stevens, and a travel's called, and the Taranaki crowd look nonplussed, and a lot of contact there, but referee's call is travel. And Coach Cowie brings O'Connell to the bench now for the first time this game. So probably, at least in this game, their two best players, Emily Poole and Caitlin O'Connell, both sitting on the bench now with 2 minutes left in the second quarter, down four. Probably look to give them a nice break along with that 5 minute halftime, get them fresh for that second half. And it's a risky move bringing out your star players in a game like this, especially when you see Dominic Stevens just grab an O board and put it back in. Waikato extend their advantage to six, but it could pay off late in the fourth quarter if his star players are more rested, as we see Walker Ekitone and Dominic Stevens and Kiani Leith all been on the court for the duration of the game so far. Taranaki, a really stagnant offense right now. They're really still, and that shows with the type of shot they managed to produce. A really contested shot, it was blocked. And getting back in transition defense isn't good right now for Taranaki. And that is just way too easy. That's a real coach killer. I mean, make or miss on that layup, but Taranaki can't afford to be lazy in transition defense and stagnant on offense. And this could be a symptom of guard Caitlin O'Connell sitting on the bench right now. Be interesting to see how long Coach Cowie rides with this, even though there's only 57 seconds left in the second quarter. And they get it down to Sampson straight away on the low post. And a travel is called. And you'd have to say so far in the battle of the bigs between Emily Poole, Raquel Sampson from Taranaki, Dominic Stevens from Waikato has really got the edge on them at the moment.
and she is just looking really good out there. It'll be really interesting to see how these players are going still in that fourth quarter if they're required to play 40 minutes. Again, really easy entry pass into the high post as part of Waikato's offense to Stevens, and Taranaki really don't seem concerned with stopping that, but travel there on Stevens, so Waikato does get the ball back, and they bring the ball up with Blyde now, and they get it to Owen with a tough shot, and that doesn't fall for her. Walker Ikitone up the floor now. Lee threw some contact, manages to put the shot up. Really smart there. She sort of weaved her way into the gap there. Whistle, heard a whistle, put a shot up, and that's smart basketball. Makes the second. That extends Waikato's advantage to 7 now. Taranaki will get the last shot here. They've got the ball 20 seconds left, and they bring the ball up right now. They get it back to Smith. Smith still with it at the top. Right into the post to Sampson. That's where they're looking to get, and Stevens with the block. And that's halftime, and the halftime score is Waikato 29, Taranaki 22. And this coverage is brought to you by broadcast partners NTech, and we're live streamed on the NZ Herald website. Right now, I can look over from where I'm sitting in the boys' quarterfinal, Canterbury 40, Wellington 36. And for more information, you can visit the Basketball New Zealand website, basketball.org.nz. And for all other tournament information, results and photos, the Basketball New Zealand Facebook page and Twitter at BasketballNZ. We'll take a quick break over the 5 minute halftime, and we'll see you in the second half.
Hi, and welcome to Kiwi Hoops TV. My name is KP, and today we have two special guests with us. We've got Kiwi Hoops coach Dave Mackay and basketball parent and former netball legend, Tanya Dawkins. Today we are going to talk about the Kiwi Hoops program that an anyday Kiwi can take to learn about playing, coaching, and refereeing basketball. Welcome to the show, guys. Dave, being the Kiwi Hoops coach, how successful has the program been today?
That's a great question, KP. The Kiwi Hoops program by Basketball New Zealand is fantastic. It's exceptional for introducing parents to coaching, refereeing, and all the players. It's certainly a good program, particularly if you're new to the sport, because it has a high focus on primary school age kids.
Can you explain how the Kiwi Hoops program is structured?
It's an athlete-centered structured program, meaning that we concentrate on the key fundamental skills needed, but at the same time teach the rules associated to the game and also keep it really fun.
Tani, as a former elite sportswoman and now a basketball fan, how helpful did you or other parents find the program?
Look, the Kiwi Hoops program ensures parents like myself can easily teach the young basketballers the key fundamentals of the game, which is we all know is so important. It also provides an entry level in terms of pathway for coaching. So from an ex-netballer's point of view, this program is extremely informative.
Thanks, Tanya. We're now going to cross over live to our man on the ground, as he is a coach development director with him to explain more about the program. KP, are you there?
Yes, thanks, KP. I'm here with Matu Taifale from Basketball New Zealand. Can you tell us more about the program?
Yeah, sure, KP. Kiwi Hoops teaches people about basketball in a fun and enjoyable way. It's mainly for people for the ages of 5 to 13, and they work through four different stages as they go through the program. Not only does it focus on players and coaches, but it also caters for the growing referee community. It's all about making coaching and refereeing easy for our parents, our older siblings, senior students, and anyone who might want to help out in basketball. And who knows, it could be a lifetime passion of theirs.
Making the coaching more complex and difficult, the Kiwi Hoops program is trying to make it more simple. Is that right?
You're spot on, KP. Ultimately, the key part of the program is to provide education for coaches, players, parents and volunteers to help develop players and referees in a fun setting. The program's designed to meet the needs of young players initially to maintain the essence of our game.
Thanks. Back to you, KP.
Thanks, KP. I have personally been through the Kiwi Hoops program myself, and I have improved on my shooting and my dribbling. Maybe Dave's players could be doing a training because of this year's performance. What do you think of that, Dave?
Yeah, well, I think you're right. That's
all we have time for today, guys. Thanks for tuning in to Kiwi Hoops TV. You should go visit your local association, and we hope to see you soon.
And we're back for the second half of this under 15 girls semi-final between Waikato and Taranaki. Waikato have the advantage at the moment, 29-22. And we've seen star players for Waikato, Dominique Stevens and Quay Walker Ikitone, really dominate the ball. And unfortunately for Taranaki, Emily Poole, that one of their star bigs, has been in foul trouble, but Caitlin O'Connell's done a really great job keeping their offense measured. And Raquel Sampson's been battling tough with Dominique Stevens inside. Be interesting to see what adjustments the coaches have made the 5-minute halftime break. With Waikato seemingly running their offense quite easily, walking the ball up the floor, not much pressure on. And they can get into their offense quite easily, which is probably dangerous against Waikato, who are very well coached. They have coach Tyler Wilkinson, very experienced coach with multiple national titles. And they need to probably find a way to disrupt Waikato's flow and rhythm on offense. On the other side of the ball, be interesting to see if Waikato's going to still deny Caitlin O'Connell the ball full court. There's a really nice block there from Sampson, and O'Connell's out and running on the fast break. Nice and measured, no layup there, so she just pulls it out. And don't get the ball inside on this one. Poole ends up getting it, but she's out on the three-point line. A nice Eurostep rip-through move from Emily Poole there. Manages to draw the foul on number five, Honor Wilson. As we see Emily Poole go to the line, and she unfortunately misses the first. And manages to make the second. And the start of the second half is always a really important time in a basketball game. You know, Taranaki has come out there down seven, and if they manage to make that game equal again because they come out strong, that's a real advantage to them, and momentum will be with them. But if Waikato came out strong, you know, they extend that advantage to double figures. But a really nice reverse layup there from Honor Wilson, making up for that foul down the other end. But as I was saying, if Waikato come out strong at this the start of the second half, they could put the game in double figures, and that is hard to come back from against a polished team like Waikato, as we see O'Connell drive nice and hard through a lot of traffic, but this time Stevens gets the better of her and blocks her. Walker Ikitone really protecting the ball against O'Connell's extended pressure again, and Stevens just catches it there. Come off that handoff again. Great defense by O'Connell, I thought, but a foul's been called on Caitlin O'Connell there for blocking. And so Waikato Hemi Ta'ala will go to the line for two shots. And she makes the second. She makes the second, and that extends their advantage to 10 points. And this is a really, really important part of the match now for Taranaki. Shot selection is going to be really important, and that's a really nice drive from Poole. Dump off to Sampson, and she just misses that open layup. And unfortunately for her right now, that's a crucial miss, because you don't want to give Waikato a double-digit advantage for very long. Really great defensive presence there from the bigs. Almost a turnover. And we're still in the backcourt. But Poole showing her versatility. Bringing the ball all the way up the floor. Driving hard. And that's a blocking foul. So Poole really is a crucial player. And she's on three fouls. Again, Taranaki now down 10. After starting off so hot with 10 points early in the game, haven't been able to score much since then. And they've been unfortunate with some missed layups, as we saw before from Sampson. These free throws will be really crucial, and she misses the first. Managed to make the second, and that was a really important make for Taranaki to make sure they stay within 9 right now of this Waikato side. And Taranaki need to find a better way to make advantage of the bigs they have, because one of their bigs is getting marked by a guard, and they really need to find a way to take advantage of that. Really, really, it's poor defense from Taranaki there. That was a very easy drive for a national semifinal right through the middle of the paint for a simple layup. And again, Caitlin O'Connell's been put under extended pressure, managed to get the ball back to initiate their offense. It's still quite stagnant. I mean, their post player is still on the low post, and there's a bit of movement from them. And shot selection is going to be really crucial for Taranaki. They really can't afford to be down. It's 35-24 right now, and they can't afford to be down big to Waikato and get offensive plays like that. And they give up a foul there, and Waikato will go to the line to try and extend their advantage further into double figures. Now good pass and cut from Taranaki, and they really need that to fall. And it's Waikato ball, and Waikato's really taken a hold of this game right now. They're up 13. Taranaki really struggling to find good shots at the moment. As we see O'Connell put extended pressure on Walker Katoni, she's asking for her teammates to help, and unfortunately for O'Connell, none of her teammates willing to also apply extended pressure, and their effort is to no avail there. Again, a really easy drive for Waikato, right into the no-charge circle for a very simple layup. Taranaki's help defense really needs to step up when a player's beat like that. O'Connell with an errant pass to Poole. Manages to save it, though. And O'Connell and Poole playing together now. Really sweet pass on that pick and roll from O'Connell, and Poole with an excellent finish. Right through a little bit of contact as well. No foul on that, though, but huge basket for Taranaki to go from 15 to 13. And again there, Waikato is just getting right into the key anytime they want right now, as we see again Leith really doing well, and that's an and one. Plain puts them straight back up 15. Taranaki's working so hard for their shots on the other end, and Waikato just come down this end and seemingly stroll right into the paint, and Taranaki have to find an answer for this very fast. O'Connell chases down the rebound. They only need to get some transition layups here. Nice move and nice finish there from number six, Paris Mason. Again, we see that Alpo entry, and Walker Gattoni gets right past for a layup and one again. And Taranaki perhaps might be looking to call a timeout at the moment. Walker Gattoni nails that free throw and really puts the advantage right in Waikato's court. And you see Caitlin O'Connell's coming off right now. Only 4.5 minutes into the third. And unfortunately for Caitlin O'Connell, that is her third foul. So she's going to have to sit down. And that is a really, really risky move from the Taranaki coach at this stage. They need baskets, and their other guards are just going to have to step up right now. I tell you who is stepping up, Emily Poole with a strong move. Just misses, but great O-board, and that rims out as well. But Taranaki just, and that's what they need to do. They just need to work hard, really hustle after it, dive on the floor when they can, sprint harder and box out harder than the other team to really get this lead back. And they're going to want to get this lead back to single digits as soon as they can. So Walker Gattoni just walks the ball up the floor. You see Waikato set up in their offense. And we've seen this a lot, and great move from Stevens. Just manages to read the play instead of taking the handoff. Instead of giving the handoff to Walker Gattoni, she just turns and drives herself and gets fouled and almost finishes through that contact as well. And we might have to remember this name, Dominique Stevens, a really strong big. There's not a lot of bigs in women's basketball in New Zealand, and this could be one to watch out for. Really nice shot as well, finishes that free throw, and that puts Waikato up 15 at the moment. And Taranaki show no signs of reducing this margin. And are up to 16, the largest lead of the game right now for Waikato. Good pass. And a reverse layup, a really nice reverse layup from Liana Smith there, puts the game back to 14 points. And Taranaki bench is picked up now, they're chanting. And they are right, they're going to need some stops here. They're going to need a few stops together. As we see a stoppage in the game, as again, the ball is on the court. And Waikato will get to set up an inbounds play here. Stevens just asking for it in the post. It's a really good drop step and a left-hand finish, and unfortunately for her it just runs out, but a really strong move from Stevens, and she is a really impressive player. And just in the backcourt there, probably an unnecessary reach-in from Reese Anderson there, but we see Anderson in the game now, and Tyler Wilkinson, coach of Waikato, able to use her bench a little bit more with a comfortable cushion. Taranaki with an on-ball screen here, and they just look for Emily Poole, and really strong finish. And these two bigs are just going at it right now, and that's huge, a 12-point game now. And Taranaki bench are really up, they're really going now, and they're going to need some stops right here if they want to make it a game. And that handoff to Ekatoni again, no help defense, and that's a really nice left-hand layup from her. And you really have to say right now, Waikato are able to really every time put it into Stevens in that high post near the three-point line and come off a handoff. And Taranaki really aren't stopping it. And if you don't have the ability to stop the other team from doing what they want to do, you're probably going to have a tough time at when you get to national semi-finals and finals. And this perhaps could be a symptom of the pool they were in. Unfortunately for them, they had quite an easy time in their pool play. Waikato on the other end, they had 27, 25-point wins against Otago and North Harbour B, a big win against Tasman, and they were challenged a little bit there, a 13-point game in their pool with Palmerston North. And they managed to really beat Waitakere West quite comfortably in the quarterfinals this morning. A team that had some really close games themselves and looked like a title contender. And Waikato again just showing at this stage of the tournament it's just the intangible stuff that gets you there. And right now they're able to run their offense, you know, they're able to play good defense, and they're able to rebound and get the shots that they want. And yeah, she misses that, but Waikato firmly in control of the semi-final. See, Mitchell to the line now for her second shot. See, Taranaki's put in bottom age player Gemma Walsh into the game for the first time. And it's number 14. And this will be a really good experience for her in a national semi-final. Under 14 player. As we see a foul in the backcourt on Tyler Mitchell. And that is Waikato's fifth foul. And so that's a foul you don't want to give away. A foul in the backcourt, and Taranaki get to walk the ball at the floor and take two shots, as we see. Coach Andy Cowley right now has Raquel Sampson and Caitlin O'Connell sitting down on the bench for an extended period. And if this group that's out there that can get back to 10 points, Coach Cowley might be really confident in his team's position as they put O'Connell back on the floor. And the fight Taranaki need right now, I mean, they need a dive on that. You know, they just need to want it more. And right now, it's just plays like that. Poor transition defense, and Waikato just seem to want it more. And at this level, that's where it counts, as we see a really nice and one play there from Hemi Ta'ala, as the advantage is extended. Missed free throw there. Poole with another rebound. And if I look at the live stats, I can see Taranaki are really out rebounding Waikato. As we see a really nice move and really nice finish there from Liana Smith. Taranaki's out rebounding Waikato. They've got almost 10 more rebounds, but Waikato is just able to do what they want out there almost, as we see a lot of rebounds there from Waikato. Dominic Stevens trying to make me eat my words, but she cannot finish that layup there. And we're at 50-37 right now, so really important last 2 minutes of this quarter for Taranaki. And Emily Poole asking for the ball. Walsh on the drive, and she's fouled, and that's a really strong drive from her. The first time she's in the game, third quarter, and I think it's the first time she's touched the ball, bottom edge player, and she just drives hard to the hoop, no fear, and that's really great to see from the little guard. And the Taranaki crowd on the sideline loves it as she manages to convert that free throw, putting it back to a 12-point margin. Oh, and an errant pass there, but Walker Katoni manages to track it down. And Waikato not really in their offense right now, but right now it's Waikato really out-rebounding Taranaki, and we could be seeing that as a symptom of Emily Poole. Now, she's not getting rebounds. Who is right now for Taranaki? And we see a bad turnover in the backcourt. And as much as Taranaki might pull this margin back, it's really hard to see them getting the lead back from Waikato here. if they don't stop Waikato's offense and they don't find a way to stop Dominic Stevens. And I mean, Emily Poole is a great player and she's doing a really great job, but you need a team to step up here, and the help side defense has been absent as Waikato's been able to drive and Waikato's been able to run their offense really well here. Taranaki will really have to make some adjustments at fourth quarter, really come out with a bit more heart and hustle if they want to take this game. Bit of a stoppage right now as Coach Andy Cowie of Taranaki has a bit of a conversation with the referees. And we resume play now with the free throws, and it's 52-40 now. And Coach Tyler Wilkinson looking to take a timeout, perhaps looking to take advantage of some of the holes on the court there, as Raquel Sampson and Caitlin O'Connell both sitting down. Coach Cowie really looking to motivate his players right now, and I mean, well, the X's and O's are nice and being able to stop Waikato's offense would be nice and running your own offense, but he's probably right in that right now Taranaki, they just need to want it more. I mean, they're getting out sprinted in transition, and with the game as close as it is, that's a very easy thing to turn around. So if they can come out with a bit more fire, we might really see a game in the fourth quarter. Plays resumed here again. We see Walker Ikitone dribbling up the floor against tough pressure there from Waikato's number 8 Ashby, and she steps out of bounds. And there you go, some extended pressure from Taranaki looking to get Waikato away from being able to walk it up and instantly produce results. That's really great to see. Inbound pass straight to Emily Poole with a mid-range jump shot. Oh, air ball unfortunately. Reverse layup attempt doesn't fall, but they're really getting over boards here. Number 10 pulls up for three and she hits it. That's a huge shot and we're back. Liana Smith's three makes it a single digit game once again. I mean, but once again, I mean, they got to travel and momentum's really going Taranaki's way now, and you see how quickly things can change in basketball. Once again though, Taranaki's really going to want to shore up their defense as Hemi Ta'ala really managed to just get into that key quite easily there, and we see Gemma Walsh gets tied up. Some really good extended pressure from Waikato, and perhaps Coach Tyler Wilkinson called that timeout to go in for the kill. With Caitlin O'Connell still down on the bench, I'm sure Coach Cowie will look to play her for the entire fourth quarter, and he will be definitely pleased. You know, if Taranaki get a score here, put it back to 8 points. You know, we're really looking at a game again as Walker Tony trying to put pressure on. Pass right into Poole. A lot of contact there, but no call. So great job by Dominic Stevens. She's really doing a great job using all of her length. But again, we see nobody looking to stop Kimi Ta'ala until about the no charge circle, and defense really needs to step up and transition before that. And that's a real killer for Taranaki, and I can see the frustration from where I'm sitting on Coach Cowie's face. Taranaki again pulling up for three, and fortunately they missed that shot. But they really just hustle with the ball. Great job. And that's exactly what they need. TN Owen right there doing a great job for Taranaki, number seven, tying the ball up, really getting after it. And there's 1.2 seconds left in this quarter. Good call from Coach Cowie here with a bit of extended pressure. Really just make sure Waikato don't get a shot off. Walker Ketone sort of showing her composure and just catching the ball, and that'll be the quarter. So three-quarter time, Waikato 54, Taranaki 42. And we're back for the fourth quarter. Taranaki coming out with their starting lineup. And it's go time now. 10 minutes left, down 12. They really need to make a show of coming back for it. So the start of the fourth quarter is going to be really important. We see a strong drive from Mason. Looks to dump it off to Sampson, but her hands aren't up to the task. And Waikato get the ball back. Some extended pressure again from O'Connell. Walker Katoni asking for help. Mason trying to help. Didn't quite get there in time, and she's burnt quite easily there by Waikato. She drives on two players, and the ref manages to bail out what would be quite a tough shot there for her. But two shots for Waikato, and Taranaki can't be happy with that start. Taranaki get it up the court now. It's a strong drive there from Emily Poole, and she's rewarded with a foul call. And Taranaki really showing some determination to really score here, and they're down 12. They're going to have to pull something out, and refs aren't calling that a shooting foul, so Taranaki ball on the sideline now. As we see Tyler Mitchell come on for Honor Wilson for Waikato right now. Player resumes, they get the ball straight into Emily Poole in the post. And that's a really nice move. Just a turn, a drop step, keeps the ball high, doesn't dribble. That's a really good fundamental move from a young big. Paris Mason picks that pass off right to Poole again, and she draws a foul on Stevens. And Taranaki have some energy back in their game right now. And they've got the ball on the baseline right now. It's really great to see Taranaki playing with energy again, and they're going to need to convert that to points. O'Connell, strong drive, dumps it off. Poole misses the layup. Sampson with the O-board puts it in, though, and we're back to a 10-point game with 9 minutes left. O'Connell putting extended pressure on Walker Ikitone. She falls. And O'Connell probably needed to dive on that. But Ikitone gets back up. 10 seconds left on the shot clock. And there you go. That's what we've been talking about all game, trying to deny that pass into Stevens. I mean, that's how Waikato has been initiating all of their offense, just a pass into Stevens in that high post. Unfortunately, a foul, but it's good to see Taranaki coming up with a bit of purpose and intention. We see O'Connell up on Walker Ikitone again. Pass into Stevens, she catches quite high this time, but she just drives right to the key, and that's poor defense from Sampson. Unfortunately, she fouls, and Stevens does a great job there, and she'll go to the line. So right now, Waikato is still up 8, and next we have the North Harbour girls up against the Canterbury girls, where if Waikato and North Harbour win, we'll see a repeat of last year's final. And Stevens misses both free throws there. Great rebound from Sampson. And O'Connell's away down the court. Tyler Mitchell putting a lot of pressure, but a great screen on Emily Poole. Errant pass from O'Connell. Sampson kicks it out to Mason, kicks it out to O'Connell. It's a long two. And a foul's called over the back on Sampson, and she's gutted by that call. But Stevens did a great job boxing out and probably earned that call. You see O'Connell with extended pressure again on Walker Ikitone. Her teammates really aren't helping her, though. No one else putting extended pressure on. And again, we see number 10 for Waikato, Keani Leith, just gets right into the key. They don't even need a run in offense. She just gets right into the key. And Taranaki really need to step up now. We're with 8 minutes left in their national semifinal. Down 9. They really need to stop that. And a long two there. O'Connell with the defensive rebound. Passes up the court. Waikato quell that fast break. O'Connell on the drive. And a charging foul on Caitlin O'Connell. And that'll be her fourth personal foul. But Coach Cow will have no chance to leave her out there. And he's not happy with that call, as I imagine most of the Taranaki supporters are not. It's hard to imagine a girl Caitlin O'Connell's size getting a charge, but great defense from Waikato, and Walker Ikitone back up on the court. O'Connell playing great defense on her. Easy pass into Stevens again to initiate their handoff offense. They drive right through, and that's an and-one play. And that is a huge moment in the game right now as Waikato gets it back out to double digits. Misses the free throws, but Stephen gets that rebound, misses that left-hand shot. And we see O'Connell with the ball now. Messy play from Taranaki, and a travel. A couple of rough calls for Taranaki there, but that's the way the dice rolls right now, and they're down 11 with 7.5 minutes left. And they've lost a bit of energy to their game. Last two possessions being a turnover through a charge foul and a travel. Again, O'Connell's playing great defense on Walker Ikitone, and she's just equal to the challenge, though, right there. And again, they're quite happy to let Stevens catch in that high post sort of area there, and she drives right to the hoop, misses. A three-point shot there. Huge three-point shot from Keani Leith, putting Waikato up now 60-46. Tyler Mitchell with extended pressure along with Walker Ekitone, and almost Taranaki turned the ball over again. You really can't afford, with 7 minutes left in a national semi-final, three turnovers in a row, or three possessions in a row without a score, and Taranaki really going to need to look to get a score here. Dumping inside to Poole. It's been their bread and butter. Nice pass to Sampson, and that's a great layup. They really need that. Again, we see Leith right into the paint. Better defense from Sampson, but tough shot from Leith. And Waikato's outscoring in transition. That's all we didn't see a lot of in the first half of this game. Didn't see a lot of transition baskets. Both teams play quite good transition defense. There's great defense there from number seven, Leila Hemitiala. And the possession ends in a pull basket. It's Taranaki. Still at the moment, down 12. Stevens catching it high again. 3-point shot from Hemitiala. Misses. Tyler Mitchell tracks down that rebound, and Sampson's pulled up for another foul. And she's just a little late getting to the spot and doesn't really show her hands, unfortunately for her. Oh, sorry, the foul's on Emily Poole. And she's fouled out now, and with 5 minutes 50 left, Emily Poole fouled out. Down 12, Taranaki. Their hopes of getting to a national championship final has just taken a bit of a blow. Raquel Sampson is really going to have to step up for them inside, guarding Dominique Stevens. And the battle between Walker Ekitone and O'Connell has been great to watch, but really inside, Stevens has really gotten the better of Taranaki. And that is really the matchup where the game's been won. Sampson with a great D board there. Managed to get it to O'Connell. Great extended pressure right now with Walker Ekitone. Mitchell just helping out, stabbing at the ball. O'Connell trapped. Managed to get Mason. Get it to Sampson inside. Stevens with the foul. She's not sure why, but probably a foul on that play. And that'll be her third personal foul. 5.5 minutes left. That's not a worry for her. That's the first, and that Taranaki crowd is really loving that. Just that run at the start of the second half really extended the lead to double digits for Waikato, and now match has really stayed there since. And Taranaki's going to need to find a way to go on a run themselves. And you can see the effect Dominic Stevens has had on the game. 16 points, 17 rebounds. Seven of those rebounds are O-boards, 10 defensive rebounds. Again, Stevens initiating the offense. Back to Walker Ekitone, a 3-point shot. Waikato just out-hustling Taranaki right now. Tyler Mitchell just coming up with play after play. Tyler Mitchell, 2 points, 3 rebounds. Not a huge box score play, but she's just doing the little things, hustling after the basketball. Huge block there from Sampson, but Walker Ekitone just rips it off her, and Stevens right there again. With 18 points, 17 rebounds right now. Huge performance in a national semifinal. And a travel's called on Paris Mason for Taranaki. And a timeout for Taranaki. And this will be their last ditch attempt. 65-51, 14-point game with 4.5 minutes to go in their national semifinal. Waikato will look to close the door on Taranaki right now as they look to reach the national final once again. This will be Waikato's third under 15 final in a row. Last year, of course, winning it, led by MVP Charlize Ledger-Walker. And the year before that, losing to coach Angela Parrott-Hunt's ACM under 15 girls. And we're back here. Walker Okotone with the ball. Of course, Caitlin O'Connell matched up on her, playing good defense. And a travel's called. Great defense from O'Connell there. And they're down 14. They need every call they can get, every little advantage they can get right now. Tough inbound pressure, but Taranaki managed to get the ball in. Really nice drive there, but she's driving into two people. Great helps their defense from Waikato. That's probably been one of the major differences in the match. Every time Taranaki drive, and a foul there, so Sampson will go to the line. But every time Taranaki drive, there's one or two players in help defense there for Waikato. And when a Waikato player drives, they manage to get to the hoop or they're getting a foul. Of course, it helps when you have Dominique Stevens waiting in there in the key. She hits the first big free throws here for Sampson. And again, looking at the live stats, Taranaki have 16 turnovers to Waikato's 15. And that's a really good amount. I mean, they're really not playing messy basketball. We've seen some good shooting, seen some really multi-skilled players. And to see basketball like this, a lot of half-court basketball as well, is really great for the New Zealand women's game. And the New Zealand women's game has really gone from height to height in the last few years. Tall Ferns got a win in Spain against the number three ranked Spain in the world this year with Coach Kennedy Kiriyama. And the under 17 national girls last year really fought hard with Australia, coached by Jodie Cameron, and they did a really good job against Australia. And Australia ended up winning the under 17 world champs, and that just shows you we really could have competed at that world champs level. Unfortunately, it's a consequence of the Oceania zone, and it's really great that New Zealand will be in that Asia Pacific zone next year, which our under 17 girls will get to compete in. In the last few years, the New Zealand under 16 girls, coached by Angela Parrott-Hunt again, have had the best two results they've had in the state champs over that last 2 years. So we're seeing some of the best New Zealand teams ever at all levels in the women's game right now. And then even at our national under 15s, we're seeing some really talented bigs, some really great smart guards, and we're really producing some multi-skilled players who are really playing the game that I'm sure in the next few years we'll be really capable of playing at an international level. So we're really getting into the last part of the game now. Less than 3.5 minutes to go. Waikato with another tough drive into the key. It's really patient offense from them, not willing to force up too much. Again, another offensive rebound, and that's a killer for Taranaki at the moment. 3.5 minutes left, 3 minutes left now, 13-point gap. And a foul. So these free throws here could make it a 15-point game with less than 3 minutes left. And you'd really think, barring a miracle here, Waikato will be returning to the under 15 girls final for the third year straight, looking to defend their title as they did last week in Auckland with the under 17 girls title. Caitlin O'Connell's been double-teamed here by Walker Ikitone and Leith. She's really asking for some help from her teammates, but still manages to get open. Extended pressure from Leith there, and O'Connell brings the ball up the floor calmly to initiate Taranaki's offense. Down 15 here, and a travel's called against Taranaki, and you really have to commend Coach Tyler Wilkinson on her well-drilled Waikato side. You know, they're either getting into the paint with aggressive drives, or they're just being really patient. They've almost had a good shot on every offensive possession with a really great offense, a lot of movement. And again, it's really good for the women's game. This is an international level offense. They're running a lot of movement, on ball screens, some handoffs. It's a basket there for Taranaki. It could be too little too late though at this stage. 13 point game still. And Walker Ikitone, calm as you like, initiating their offense. Stevens once again, just a little step through. Sampson managed to get the rebound as that shot rims out. O'Connell with the ball. Taranaki really probably need to look to rush the pace, and 13 points, couple of quick baskets. They need a really desperate minute here, but I don't know if they have that desperation or belief left in them at this stage, and that's a turnover and Leith. Leith is just a one-man wrecking machine, and O'Connell just a little late to get in front, but she, you can't fold her. She really is sprinting and getting back. And Taranaki calling a timeout with a minute and a half left, 13-point game. And Coach Cowie really looked to rally his troops to try with one last-ditch effort to get as close as they can. And just look at some of the star players. You know, the point guards, Waikato point guards, Quay Walker Ikitone. He has 10 points, 6 rebounds, 4 assists, and she just does it all. And a lot of that stuff is not even on the box score. Just calm, initiates the offense, really smart, doesn't foul much, just really smart point guard. See her opposite, Caitlin O'Connell, with 8 points, 6 rebounds, 4 assists. Once again, just doing it all for Taranaki, and we saw the impact when she was out, that they really couldn't get the ball up the floor, run their offense and get good shots as easily as when O'Connell was on the floor. And again, O'Connell was in the New Zealand under 16 team that was coached by Angela Perrott-Hunt this year, and so she was the only player in that from this tournament, and she's really looked experienced out there up against Walker Ikitone. Of course, the Taranaki bigs, Raquel Sampson, she has a double-double, 11 points and 17 rebounds. You know, she's really been a beast on the boards. Unfortunately, 4 of 15 shooting, and that's just those little layups that rim out. And that is really a big difference in the match. Emily Poole also with 17 points, 9 rebounds. Also 6 of 17 shooting. Unfortunately, some of her shots rim out. And that's just how it goes sometimes. Those big shots rim out, whereas you look on the other end, Dominique Stevens. She is 18 points, 20 rebounds. So, such a dominant performance from Dominique Stevens. And you have to say, if she can produce a game like this in the final, and it'll be either against Harbour or Canterbury, she could well be looking at MVP honours. And as I've said before many times, that's a name to remember, Dominique Stevens. Again, 18 points, 20 rebounds in a national semi-final. Huge performance as we see Walker Ikitone step to the line, up 12 in the national semi-final. And Sampson with another rebound. That'll be her 18th rebound of the game. And these bigs, they're really strong, and they're really talented. A lot of the times at this age, you know, the bigs, they're not quite coordinated, not quite grown into their bodies yet. But these bigs, they're multi-skilled players. I mean, we saw Emily Poole knock down a mid-range jump shot. You know, we're seeing Dominique Stevens comfortable handling the ball from the three-point line, driving in a range of moves. Walker Ikitone with an acrobatic layup, and she gets her own rebound. And again, both Caitlin O'Connell and Walker Ikitone getting rebounds, assists, and points out there. It's really do-it-all point guards. And who knows, if they really keep improving like they are, they could be teammates on the New Zealand stage very soon. And Tyler Mitchell with a bank three, and that just puts an exclamation point on Waikato's semi-final win. And so they'll be going through to the national final. Third year in a row, really dominant Waikato program over the last few years. As we see the game wind down now, strong drive from Taranaki. Waikato not interested in fouling. last possession here now. 20 seconds left in the national final. And that's a needless foul there, but they'll now go to the line for two shots. And this Taranaki team's done really well. You know, they are one of the best teams in this tournament. They've really blown out a lot of other good teams in this tournament. You know, beaten Canterbury Country this morning, beat other quarterfinalists Rotorua in pool play really handily. And they're a really talented team. Unfortunately for them, won't be in the national final, but they've done a really great job. And it's really good to see a team from the regions of New Zealand doing really well. So Taranaki basketball is really on the up this year. They've consistently had players in the national teams over the last few years, and they're really starting to produce some talent, some really good coaches down there as well, doing a lot of great work. As we see Waikato with their free throws, now Taranaki in the last position of the game, put up a three. And they rim out, and there it is. Final score, Waikato 72, Taranaki 58. And Waikato back to the national championship game again. Surely defending champions, finalists 3 years in a row. The undoubted best girls program in New Zealand right now in the age group game, and they will be favourites in the final tomorrow, especially with Dominique Stevens playing like she is. And they will play the winner of the Harbour Canterbury final, which we'll bring you next. Thanks to broadcast partners NTEC and tournament host Wellington Basketball Association, live streamed in the New Zealand Herald. And just to give you an update, boys quarterfinals, Wellington, hometown Wellington, a lot of hometown support, managed to get home against Canterbury 87-72, and they'll be in the semi-finals later tonight. And so for more information on the under 15 national championships, just visit the BBNZ website, www.basketball.org.nz. And for other results, tournament information and photos, just check out the Basketball New Zealand Facebook page or follow on Twitter at BasketballNZ. And you can tag us in your post with the hashtag Under15Nats. And thank you, and we'll see you for the next semi-final between Harbour and Canterbury Girls.